Okay, so let's start with the tuning of the startup of our engine, and let's show some basic and advanced methods. So let's begin with the basic stuff. First, we have to set up the alignment. So initially, we will set up the alignment taking 2 seconds, and the final current will be approximately 50 to 100% of the motor nominal current. This is to stabilize the motor if it was spinning or vibrating at one fixed position and give it enough time for stabilizing in this position.
Second part, it's a speed ramp. It's required start to some speed. Our recommendation is to use 30% of maximal application speed to speed up faster than the non-reliable part of the sensorless reconstruction. And then it's also take some time. It's in some seconds, depend on the motor or inertia connected to the rotor.
Okay, finally, we have to work with the current ramp and set up the initial and final values dependent on the required torque. So normally we'll start with a 50% of the nominal current value.
Next part, it's about the threshold in the speed, and we have to define some minimal speed, and below this speed it's not possible switch to the closed loop. We have to avoid some non-reliable reconstruction, and we define usually 15% of nominal speed for this threshold.
Additionally, to check that the speed was reached, we define some speed band tolerance limit, and the lower one shall be set to 93.75%. This is one step below 100.
Second possibility, how to describe startup, it's advanced. It's defined quite similar, but with some 5 points. First, it's alignment with final speed zero with predefined electrical angle. Then second step, start with the spinning with final speed in non-zero value and defined current. We can define 5 steps. And also there is some possibility how to define a step which is able switch to sensorless algorithm to the closed loop.
The green part now shows the length of each of the steps. So we can define the alignment length, we can define the length of our startup and so on. The second part depicted in red is the final speed in RPM defined for each step. The motor control algorithm will gradually change the speed from the one reached in the previous step to the end value of this step. So it will, for example, in the second step go from 0 to 588 RPM in 1.17 seconds. And finally, we can see the final current of each step that defines the torque ramp and the available current.
The bottom part is the same as in the basic view, and you have to again define some limit in the speed for the switching to a closed loop. And this slide, you see 2 view for the advanced view for the startup with startup table with 5 points. First, it's on the left side. First, it's setup in the workbench, which is defined to the code. And second part, it's from the monitor, and you can change this part online from motor control workbench monitor. There is only one different in the order of a column, and inside the online view, it's torque in the digits of ADC. It's not current, it's some digits and define some torque.